Hi, I'm Charles Sanderson, a chemical engineer who's been using Excel for quite a while, and I thought I'd do a couple of recordings of some of the tips and tricks I've picked up along the way, which will hopefully be useful for other people. What I'm going to talk to you about today is sort of equation solving, iteration in Excel. I'm going to use an example of a flowsheet with a recycle, but obviously there's all sorts of other equation solving where you'd want to do that. So for this process, what I'm doing is I've got a feed. I'm going to send that. It's going to be a slurry, a mixture of dissolved and suspended solids in water. I'm going to send that through a filter where I recover the suspended solids, re-slurry that cake with some more water, and then refilter it to get a clean cake with hopefully a low level of residual solids on it. The permeate, the wash water that I've sent through that second filter, I'll bring back around, add to my feed of the first filter. That's the recycle I was talking about, and that is combined with the moisture in the feed is going to then give me a diluted permeate, which hopefully is going to have the majority of my dissolved solids in it. So in the model, what I'm going to do is I'm going to track three components: the dissolved solids, the suspended solids, and the water. Obviously, this is a simple example. It can get a lot more complicated than this if you want it to be. I'm going to track those in terms of kilos an hour. I'm going to sum those to give me my total, and then I'm going to calculate the dissolved solids, which would be the measurement in the lab, where if you filtered it in the lab and then dried the material, what solids are remaining. I'm assuming my dissolved solids are non-volatile. Total solids would be, again, a measurement that's really easy in the lab, where you take the whole mixture, remove the water, dry the water out, and what have you got left is the total solids. Then the suspended solids is sometimes a bit trickier to get in the lab, because you'd have to infinitely wash the filter cake, but you can calculate it with the model directly, and you can calculate it from these two other numbers if you do a bit of algebra. Rather than make you suffer watching me type, what I've done is I've gone ahead and started building the model. So what I've done is I've created a feed stream where I'm just arbitrarily 20% dissolved solids, 10% suspended solids. So I've coloured my inputs orange just so it's easier for me to come back and find them later. I then calculate the total flow. And then, as I say, the dissolved solids is the dissolved material divided by the dissolved material in the water. The suspended solids are not part of that number, but the other two are, as you'd expect, the relative number divided by the total. The recycle stream coming back around, I don't yet know what that composition is, so I'm just going to make that up. I've colored it in gray. Again, this is just me trying to help myself for later on understand where I've got these numbers from. So gray is, at the moment, it's an input, but it's ultimately going to be a closed recycle in one of a couple of different ways. So I want to differentiate from the orange stuff, which is truly an input, and the calculated values. To get the combined, the mixture of those two, is just simply adding the sum of those two to give me the mixture. Okay, now what I've got to do is describe this first filter. And again, I'm going to cheat and sort of show you how I calculated it. What I'm going to do is calculate it in terms of the properties of the cake. So how much of the incoming suspended solids is going to leave in the cake, and what's the moisture content of that cake going to be? I'm assuming I get a perfect filtration, so 100% recovery, and solids of 50%. Very dry for most filter cakes, but this is an exceptionally easy to filter material. So what I can do then is to say, basis that solids removal, I'm getting 100% of the material. So my solids in the cake is the same as the solids in the feed. Since I know that the material is 50% suspended solids, I can get my total flow by dividing the suspended by the target. That then gives me my dissolved solids. I can find the mass that is not solid, is not suspended solid in the cake, and then multiply that by the fraction of dissolved solids in the residual material, and then finally find water by difference. Once I've got the cake characterized, I can do the permeate by difference. So I've now got this stream and this stream, subject to my guess of what this recycle is. And now basically I'm going to sort of repeat this this block of four. So I create a wash water. How much wash water is there going to be? I'm going to say I'm going to use three parts water to one part solid. So you can see my sorry, my water flow is 3 times the solids flow. And I'm going to say that it's not got any suspended or dissolved solids in it itself. The wash water is clean. So then I can get the feed by adding the cake and the wash water together. So that gives me my feed. And then I do the same calculations as over here to get my cleaned filter cake. That then gives me a value for my filtrate. And so I've got an answer. And I can start iterating using this. I can copy that. I can paste the values in here. And you can see that's starting to converge, close the mass balance. What I'll actually do is I'll come over here. Let's just turn this back to 1 and 10, I think is where I had it. What I've done here is I've done my mass balance, which is the flows in less the flows out. So I've got my feed and my wash water less the permeate and the cake for each of the three components. And then I've got for the recycle, the difference, the error in the recycle. Obviously, these numbers should be the same, or in this case, they sum to zero. They're opposite because of the way I've defined them. But it's always good to have sort of the extra check and balance. I sometimes miss a stream or make a mistake in the formulae, so having more than one way to calculate it is useful. Having got the recycle error, I can then get the sum squared errors. I use the sum product function and just multiplied it by itself to get the sum of squared errors. And then over here, I've got the recovery in the different streams. So in this case, I'm getting, well, it's not converged at the moment, but if it were converged, you can see I would have 1.7% of my dissolved material is leaving in the cake. Okay, so I showed you direct substitution as one method for solving this. So let's look at a couple of ways. Well, actually, before we do that, I'm going to do the solver just because I want to. So the order, in another video I showed how to use the solver. I will just really quickly pull it up here, assuming you've got it set up already. So I come to data, solver. I want to minimize this sum of squared errors by changing the recycle stream's composition. So I hit solve, and it whirs away, and you can see it's converged nicely. The sum of squared errors is 10 to the minus 11, so it's pretty much a good solution. So I know that with a wash ratio of 5, I'm going to get about a 98%, 99% recovery of my permeate in the permeate stream, and all my cake is leaving in the cake stream. So that's one way of solving it. Let's change the inputs and see if we can get a different way, a different sort of result. So I've got 4, maybe I'm only going to get 99% recovery of solids there, and assuming that it's fines and things, I'll maybe get an 80% recovery there. So you can now see I've got a bunch more data. So I showed you direct substitution. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use that using a VB macro. VB and the whole macro space is going to be maybe a different set of talks that I do, but for right now, I'll just show you how you record it and use it. So down here, there's a record macro. You can also get at it through the developer tab, which I will show you shortly. So I'm going to record a macro. Okay. I'm going to take these values. I'm going to copy them, and I'm going to paste the values over there. So you can see it's updated my iteration, my sum of squared errors has come down, that's good. I'm going to stop the recording because that's really all I wanted to do. And then I'm going to come over to the developer tab. It's not there by default, so you may have to turn that on. So you come to file options, customize ribbon, and make sure you've got the developer tab checked. Okay, with the developer tab, I can then insert a button, which I'm going to stick here. I'm going to link it to the macro I just recorded, and I'm going to label it iterate. Oops. Okay, so now if I click this button, it'll run that macro and copy these values over here, and you can see each time I click it, the sum squared errors will come down until, yeah, it's pretty much converged. So that's a second way of converging the model and solving it. Okay, the final thing I'm going to do is show you how to use circular references. usually Excel frowns on that, and it's not a great way to do it. But what I'm going to do is show you how to, in this case, it's actually what you want. So I'm going to, again, the direct substitution is stable, so I'm going to make that equal to that. It'll tell me I have a circular reference, which is a problem. But just a second, I will, and then that one equals that. Okay, so now I've got this messed up. It's filled those with zeros because it doesn't know what to do. If you come over to here, the Options tab and Formulas, I'm going to turn on Iterative Calculations. It's set at 100 by default. I'm going to move it to 10. So then I hit OK, and now you see it's iterated for me, and it's solved, got that sum of squared errors down. And if I hit the formula again, it'll do another 10 iterations, or if I hit F9, it'll do a series of iterations and pull that sum of squared errors down. Okay, the fun thing about this now is it allows me to put in a data table, which is the last thing I'm going to show. So let's suppose I want to see how this model changes as I change the wash ratio. So I'm going to give it a wash ratio of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm going to want to look at the yield of the overall system, and maybe the concentration of material in the permeate. Okay, so having done that, concentration of material in the permeate. And I'm going to make that percentage, and so we're all good. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is highlight that cell. These are the numbers I want to change for this value. This is the formula I'm going to look at. I can come over here to the data what if analysis data table. And I've arranged it as a series of columns, so the input cell for column is going to be over here. And now I hit OK. What you can see is it's filled in all these cells for me. I'm going to just format that prettily. And so you can see it's what the data table does is it runs Excel, in this case, six times, runs this model six times, varying this input between 1 and 6, and records what my yield and concentration of material is. So now if I plot those, I can sort of start looking at optimization and what have you. I'm just going to pop that on a secondary axis. And so you can see there's a nice curvature there. As I add more and more water, I make my product more and more dilute, or my permeate material more and more dilute. But I'm recovering more and more of the permeate material up to around 99% at 6 parts of wash water per part solid. I'll stop there. There's obviously lots of other interesting things you could do with this, but there's three techniques to solving equations and getting something like a flow sheet to converge with recycle. I hope that's useful. Please give me feedback, and I will try and record some more stuff.